Welcome back to the studio. I am working again on this commission for a collector of mine. And this painting, we've added her dog into it. Her dog's name is Phoebe. And I'm working on the door right now. Jenna asked me to paint the door a plum color. So I'm using a mixture of dioxazine purple plus magenta. This just makes a really pretty plum color. And we're going to have some corn, Indian corn or maize, on the door. So I just work around my sketch of that. I'll do that later. First, I want to get my door in here. And this again is a dark mixture of dioxazine purple plus magenta. That's a special color. It's a really pretty purple color. Makes a lavender that is absolutely wonderful for wisteria and lavender. It's one of those special colors I use from time to time. Just as a beautiful color. And then the magenta gives it a little redder tone. That makes that nice plum color. Now the sun is coming in from the left, so this maize is going to cast a shadow down. And I've washed those They're not kernels. Kernels are the little parts. Anyway, I've washed the corn in with a mixture of alizarin crimson plus liquin. And then the little darker spots are a little bit of mud, which is my ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson. And I did that the other day, so it's good and dry now. And so I can paint around that, and it gives me my corn in there. I'll come back and do more work on that. But that gives me a base for my corn because it's going to have, reds and golds, and that Indian corn is so beautiful. It has all sorts of different colors in it. I'm going to let one of those husks of the corn come down. So that gives my corn shadow, and it's all also going to go up on the door frame. But I'm not worried about that right now. Or the door jamb, that part of the door is called the jam. Now we're having geraniums in this window, in that container. So they're also casting a shadow down. And what this shadow is going to do is give me a dark then in behind Phoebe, her hindquarters. Since she's white with some brown spots. So this then gives me a nice dark behind her. Edge of the wall there also cast that shadow down. So I paint my shadow in first. Clean my brush out now because I'm going to come back with a lighter color. I wipe my brush consistently with tissue. The secret to nice, clean, crisp colors on the canvas is a clean brush. Now we're using the lighter mixture of my plum color again. This is dioxazine purple plus magenta plus white. And I have a feeling I told you that other color was dioxazine purple plus magenta, and I forgot to tell you there was also a little bit of white in it. There's much more white in this mixture to lighten it up. This is the part of the door that's in sun. I'm going to go to a smaller brush now to work in some of these smaller areas. Again, I'm going to let one of those husks cast a little bit of a shadow right there. And I can even come back now with my darker color and come in through there, and it softens the edges of that shadow. And I've saved my color from the walls, so I can come back and and fix these little areas on the door jamb where I've painted back over it a little bit. I'm not worried about that right now. I get my corn. My shadow is not quite correct. This would come down a little bit more. There we go. That's more how my shadow would go. And then this will come. I'm going now, what I'm going to do here is I made that dark come up too high and I want it to paint my light color back here. So I can just scrape that paint off with my painting knife. And then when I come back and paint my lighter color, it doesn't pick up that dark color. And that way my light color stays light. Now I'm going to define this shadow a little bit more. Bring my dark here and then let the corn go back out like that. And now we're going to bring our little husk in again. There we are. And I like that little edge that it's gotten there, so I want to leave that. And I'm softening these edges of these shadows here. I just pull my brush from the dark into the light. Same with that. I want that edge of the shadow to be soft. Now we'll come down and paint the rest of this. Pretty door color. I'm going to have to, Jenna suggested that. And originally we had talked about doing that door a dark burgundy, but she said, no, let's do it plum. And I really like this color. I have to use that for one of my gallery paintings. And it's really pretty with the turquoise shutters. It's a really nice combination. My collectors come up with the coolest ideas. Well, I kind of get in a rut sometimes and do the same stuff over and over, and my collectors always come up with really neat things. It's the fun of doing commissions. Now my geranium shadows, I also soften those edges. Just don't want them to be hard because these shadows are far away from the source that's casting them, so we want the edges to be soft, particularly the geraniums. The corn's much closer, but the geraniums are further away, so we want to soften that, and all I have to do to soften it is come back with a clean brush, make sure it's wiped out, and then I can just drag over that, and that softens those edges. Come back with my darker color here and make sure this has got a little bit of light in there I need to clean up. Back and fix these little spots that came over just a little bit too far. This paint's still wet, so I can kind of drag it a little bit. And here we want to just... Now I'm going to get some of that paint on my brush. Just pull it straight down. And then here, the corn makes a little bit of shadow onto the wall there, onto that door jamb. Coming back now with my lighter color. I just want those shadows to be soft. It doesn't matter that a little of that color from the door pulled into there. That makes a nice little color surprise. Take a little smaller brush, brace my hand here against the canvas and just pull this just a little bit. There we go. Now, I'm going to take a little again of my plum color and add some more white to it. And we're going to pull the edges of the boards into the door. And I'm going to use my maul stick to brace my hand on. This is a hook that's made for lifting clothes off of a tall rack in a store, like maybe there's two or three levels, and then reach up with that and unhook the hangers off the rod. But it makes a perfect maul stick. We got this at the Container Store. Got these in, I think, 1994. But somebody told me that they still have them, so. Okay, now I come up to determine where I start my lines of the boards. I don't want a line going directly down the shadow. So I come up a little bit so that this line is going to be my guideline and it's going to be inside of the shadow. Now I need to wipe my brush because you pick up some of that dark paint. So I just want to wipe my brush. And now I'm going to make another board here. And now I'm going to, I made that a little too wide. I'm going to have to make these a little bit narrower. Okay, so I want to erase this other line right here, which is easy enough to do. I just take some of my dark paint, my dark plum mixture, and paint it out. There, erased. Now let me just put my little marks in here. Okay, there we are. So come up and down. This helps me. And I can just brace against the maul stick, and that allows me to make these lines straight and even. And they don't have to be absolutely straight. These are old buildings, and so if things are a little bit not equal or straight, it's just those old boards have warped. And just adds character. I like to watch the Home and Garden Channel. They have a show, International House Hunters. And they're always talking about, oh, we want a home with character. Well, here's a home with character. One guy said, yeah, this house, it's more than character, it's just plain old. But I like mine to have character, so we're adding some character. So if the boards aren't entirely equal, it's just part of that charm. Now I'm going to add my handle. This is a mixture of mud, which is ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson plus liquid. And just start here. And drag that into the wet paint. Keep my brush clean. And it pulls some of the paint from that door jamb, but that's okay. We don't want it to just be totally dark. And now I take a mixture of ultramarine blue plus white. Oops, too much. And that pulled up a little bit of my color from underneath, but I can just come back and forth and work this. then with my little bitty brush that I did the lines with, come back and add a little highlight along the edges. And then I also add a little, get some dark here. I didn't get enough paint on my brush. Come along here, make this edge of that wrought iron handle. And the last part then is to add the shadow from the door handle. And again, light's coming in from the upper left, so the shadow's going to fall to the right of the door handle. I really appreciate you watching my YouTube videos. Again, you know, this is a commission. If you ever want to commission a painting, you may contact me through the comment section. I also have a blog. The link is in the description below. I also have the address of the blog and my official website on the final frame of the video. So let's finish out that shadow, and there we go. There's our plum colored door. Thank you again so much, and you have a wonderful, wonderful day.